offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And an extra DB here for the Chiefs on third down.
Pass situation.
Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Throwing on first down is Breeze. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Breeze to throw on second down. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off, and nothing but daylight ahead. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a KC touchdown. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest. Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
It's Patrick Robinson there on the stop.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Now they'll throw with Breeze. And caught left side, Olsen. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Backing up. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. And the D looking like they may blitz. Now Breeze on third down. It's caught, Patton. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Now they try the right side here. And he will take this one in for an Eagle touchdown. A great effort there. With his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Eagles add six to their lead. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Now Jones. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. And quickly, they get to the line. They'll look to throw now on first down. Complete to Jones. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. And again here, we'll see the Wildcat. On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's a pinball effect, people bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there when you see these nice, explosive, strong runs. And this guy, he knows how to carry the football really well and continually wants the football. Why? He knows the offensive line's going to give him great effort, and he gives great effort himself to finish off runs. For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at third and one. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
And this is going to be incomplete.
Really good, smart play by the defense, understanding third and short, guarding the first down sticks, and being able to make a play on the football and bat it down.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. On the left hash, this from... Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He finds his target, Fuller. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. It'll be a gain of four. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. And the eighth play on this drive coming up. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Looking to throw. And oh, this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. 23 yards on the play. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And that is caught for the touchdown, Kansas City. Reuben Randall, his first touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs are able to get this back within a touchdown. He's got it, and they're back within a touchdown at 28-21. We're back now in KC. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be fielded at the 8. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Eagles' offense now, they head back on the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels. But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Breeze now on first down. And Olsen over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It'll go as a gain of 12. And it'll be first down, Eagles.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And that's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Breeze to throw on second down. Now they go screen. It's complete. It's a loss of 7. And now it's third down.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one, because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Midfield, here's Breeze. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Here's Steve Weatherford now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. He'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. And now here comes Kansas City. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments.
There goes Melvin Gordon, the 30. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Melvin Gordon, an 80-yard touchdown. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And, oh, he missed it. No good. And they'll remain down by a point. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one taken from the 7. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. And Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Ah,
the leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
On second down, here's Breeze. And caught left side, Olsen. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Third down and three. He's going to try and throw on third down. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it? Big-time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
And, of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late. He'll drop to throw. And he'll be out of bounds, getting it across the 25. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe-tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. And let's see what the defensive coordinator may have up his sleeve here to try to get this final last stand and win this football game. Gordon. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Back to throw. Sets up the screen to Gordon. He lost two there, and it's third down. Now that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage. Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. A little under 50% on fourth down conversions. This is a bit tougher. Fourth and four. Back to throw. It's caught. Jones. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
And now a first down following that long gain. Yet again, here's a wildcat look. Now the handoff comes to Gordon. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I don't know about you, partner, but I'm rubbing my eyes after that play. Did we just see that runner not get yardage? A big-time play by the defense. It does happen occasionally, even against the best running backs who are having big days.
He'll look to throw. Over the middle here to Rudolph. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6 foot, 6 inch target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6 target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
He's back to throw. And he's got Kyle Rudolph. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. And getting a look at the Wildcat here. Back to the ground now with Gordon. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
So it'll be first down here after the run. They'll give it to him right up the gut. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow. So many practices we watched over time where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there.
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? And they'll get set here looking for the two-point conversion. They'll look to throw. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. And around the goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it, because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius, as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Here comes Eagle off a possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. They'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw. That's caught inside the 20. And he is across and in for the score. And now they can tie the game in the final stages with the extra point.
Or they can go for two and go for the win. And that touchdown means a decision has to be made. Do they kick the PAT and tie it up? Or do they go for two and try and win it right now?
Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. And a little dangerous there, almost a penalty, but it does get into the end zone before going over the sideline for a touchback. And now here comes Kansas City. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Now a play fake here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They'll look to throw. He's going to go up top again. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. He's going to try and go deep again. And incomplete on the deep. If the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
And it's been loud in here so far.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
It's a loss of two, now third down.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be. But we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
First throw of overtime for Breeze. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. Size, the hands.
The speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
That throw good for four. It's second down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
To throw, it's Breeze. And Olsen over the middle. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Red zone opportunity. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the app.
And the Chiefs are going to signal for and be granted another timeout. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. And they'll run it here. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Now they'll throw with Breeze. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now Breeze on 3rd down. He's got time, and this will be caught. It's a touchdown. An absolute stunned silence here as they have come in and stolen this one in overtime. As the fans exit back out through the turnstiles, not happy looks on their faces. Feel like they probably let this one slip away at home in overtime.
I would agree with that, and their unhappiness hurts the guys at the concession stands on the way out, right? Not stopping.